There he goes again. That's huge. That's on the roof.
Welcome to Dean at Stumps, the cricket encyclopedia.
The Sri Lankans are stunned. The Zimbabweans are jubilant. Look what that means to them. The first ever series victory against Sri Lanka.
Hello and welcome to another edition of Dean at Stumps. I'm Dean Duplessis, and as per normal, it's great to be with you. Thank you for taking the time to listen to this podcast. Well, it's not only the World Cup that is approaching, but it is also the release of former Zimbabwe Test batsman Tatenda Taibu's book, his biography entitled Keeper of Faith, which will be released on the 23rd of May. And of course, it is available for pre-order on Amazon. But of course, the 23rd of May is just around the corner, so you very shortly will not have to worry about pre-ordering it. You can simply just buy it. Well, Taibu has never been a stranger to controversy, and I caught up with him a couple of weeks ago, and I asked him whether his book, Keeper of Faith, would have any controversy in.
Oh, definitely. I mean, you've known me long enough to know that, you know, I just say things as they are, whether it may be deemed dangerous or maybe unfair or, you know, whatever, however it's deemed, when truth is truth. Whether other people accept it or don't accept it, it is the truth. It never changes. And the beauty about that, part of my life is the story never changes. You know, when I say something to you today, then, and you ask me in the next 5 years, if it's the truth, it will remain the same story. So, and I've been happy to be a free man in that regard, that I'm able, I don't have to wonder, if Dean asked me for an interview, what did I say last time? You know, so that it coincides. But I know that I just say the truth. So whatever is the truth, you can say it out 30 more times. So what it is there's going to be a bit more revealing to the actual events that were transpiring. So a few names mentioned. And to give really a lot of flesh to what people would have read and heard about, say, in the newspaper, on radio, whatever, because that's never really the full story. Because as a reporter, you always have a certain time. If it's 30 minutes, you can't cover everything in 30 minutes. So, but there is a lot more that will be happening, and the Keeper of Faith is going to be revealing all this.
I mean, obviously, I'm not going to expect you to divulge too much, because that's what happens when you buy the book. But for the listener, just give them a bit of a teaser as to what truths will be revealed in Keeper of Faith. Just give us a little bit of a, you know how you walk into the kitchen and you sample a bit of meat from the chef's pot. That's, if you can do that, that would be great.
Okay, let me just maybe give a couple. You know, people have said to me, or in the UK, that is, have said, Tatenda, you say, you know, it comes out in the on media, on one media platform, that you missed your game because you went to the wrong venue. I said, how can that be possible? Because you would have been practicing with the team, and then all of a sudden, you know, this comes out. How does that happen? So I said, oh. I said, that's one example of what I'm talking about. So when I was supposed to make my first class debut, I did not practice with the team. I wasn't told that I was playing. I only had a little memo from Stephen Mangongo, who at that time was heading Takashinga. Yeah. So what really transpired with that is there in the book. My ODI debut, I read it in the paper that I was playing the day before the game. So these are some of the things I'll be explaining exactly what will be going on. I'll be giving detail to what transpired when it really got dangerous for us to be in the country, when we had to leave the country, when Loveness almost got kidnapped. People read about how dangerous it was, but... I'm giving a bit more flesh.
Yeah.
Loveness did almost get kidnapped. And I'll be giving, you know, a bit of that as well. There's also, you see, the spiritual life. You know, there was a story about Tatenda leaving cricket for, you know, to become a pastor, which is not correct. However, there is that 3 years when I was away from cricket and what was going on in my spiritual life that, you know, people will be very interested to know, because I know that I disappointed a lot of fans when I made that decision. But I'm sure after reading and understanding what was going on during that time, people will be very, you know, will be more understanding.
Yeah. Do you regret those 3 years leaving? Do you think that maybe that was a bit hasty, or do you still have no regrets?
I do not have any regrets, Dean. I say it without regret again now that has given me a lot of purpose, and it's explained a lot of things for me in life in general. You know, when during that time I was involved in praying for the sick, you know, praying for the hopeless and things like that. And then when you pray for someone that has lost hope, or when you start to speak to someone who has lost hope, and by God's grace, you are able to uplift such a one to a point where they start to have faith and then get healed. There is no joy. I can score, you know, 100s. There is no joy that can fulfill a heart more than that for me. So I had several of such situations where, God would use me in a way to uplift someone, or to uplift someone who's sick and has got a rare disease and has been given up by the doctors because they can't perform the operation because of the low blood sugar and things like that. And then to know that you can still visit that same person today and they are well and healthy and happy, it fills my heart even now speaking about it. So that has given me a different perception of life than the one that I had.
You obviously came back and played a little bit of cricket in Sri Lanka and played a bit of first-class cricket there, got a half century, if I remember correctly. Mm. What was that like? I mean, that would have been totally different playing your cricket in Zimbabwe and then suddenly playing cricket, first-class cricket in Sri Lanka. Or was it actually any different? What was that experience like?
First of all, you know, when you're a popular figure, it's very difficult to just make a decision and then just go with that decision without the world wanting to know, you know, what this is all about. I found that part a little bit difficult because, you know, that decision came by when I just wanted to show my boy that I can still play the game. So, you know, after a conversation we had had. However, to be honest with you, I found it fairly easy. The only thing that I failed to do was to convert, you know, a lot of 30s and 40s into big hundreds, which never used to be a problem with me.
Yeah, yeah.
I did speak to Dev Houghton about it when I came back to the UK. And he said, Tatenda, it's amazing as it is that after 6 years, you found first-class cricket in the subcontinents, turning wickets and things like that, fairly easy. And he was giving me examples of people that have left, you know, for 2 years or 3 years and struggled, you know, to get back on their feet. Because, mind you, I wasn't playing any professional cricket. Only played, you know, just 1 year of club cricket. So he said to find that fairly easy means that you are, you know, it's a rare talent. And he said, well, don't worry about the, you know, converting because it's probably just your mind or your body has forgotten how to do that. Once you get one like that, then it all comes back again. So, yeah, that's how it was.
So is there possibilities? Are there possibilities? And I can see you already know what I'm going to ask you.
I know that.
if there were to be a bit of a shake-up, a break-up and a remake-up in Zimbabwe cricket, would Tatenda Taibu once again be donning the gloves and representing, well, I suppose, first of all, first-class cricket, and then eventually the national? Is there a possibility of Tatenda Taibu once again playing international cricket for the country?
Dean, I'm sure you now understand why I hide away from you. You always have a way to try and pull my my plans ahead of time.
Just trying to rotate the strike.
Well, that's a good single there, Dean. I didn't think about that when I was making the decision. I just wanted to. To give my boy a bit of an understanding of what his dad has done in cricket, because I used to leave cricket at the ground, and I never used to bring cricket back home. So it was a big surprise for my boy to all of a sudden, we'll be walking in town and someone recognizes me in different countries. And so he always used to wonder why. So he knew that Dad was famous, but he never really knew what Dad was famous for. He knew Dad played cricket, whatever, but I never really brought cricket back home because I wanted them to know me as Dad and not to know me as superstar cricketer. And I'm glad that we, Loveness and I have managed to do that. Now, to come back to your question, Dean, I just thought of it that way and never thought of, representing my country again and things like that. Because, I mean, to be fair, there have been a lot of water that has gone under the bridge between myself and Zimbabwe cricket. And because of that, there are several barriers that if one is to start to think about, maybe playing international cricket again, there are a lot of barriers to think about. So I don't, because I want to be, I just want to be a happy person. I understand that we're only here but for a little while. And whilst I'm here, I want to, just enjoy myself and have a lovely time with my family. So because of that, I didn't entertain the thought, Dean, if I'm to answer your question that way.
Do you feel bitter and angry, and do you feel disappointed and hurt towards Zimbabwe cricket for a lot of things that have happened?
Oh, I don't. Loveness always says that she has never met anyone that moves on as smoothly as I do. I understand in life that, just having a look at how my life has gone, I understand that I'm needed in a lot of places. And because of that, I do not take anything to heart. So what the things that would have happened or things that would have transpired in Zimbabwe cricket, I see that as Zimbabwe cricket's loss, not my loss. Because I can easily go to another place and fit in and give my expertise to them, which I'm doing in the UK at the moment. The only slight disappointment there is that I'm not able to pass my expertise to my country of birth. That's why you will hear about the academy. It's just me trying to give my little expertise, back to my country of birth.
Is it an academy for very small kids, for maturing kids? What can we actually expect from this academy?
Yeah, it's just everyone who wants to get better.
Right.
So it's anyone who still feels they can, who he or she feels they can get better, even if you come in.
My gosh, that would be interesting.
Yeah, so that's it's really just just trying to make sure that he or she reaches their full potential.
Tiba, I'm going to, obviously we need to wrap it up because we'll talk cricket all day, but I'm now going to play devil's advocate because that's what we, so I would suggest to you, if you wanted to see your son play, why could he not just have had a look on YouTube and watch dad play on YouTube as opposed to making a point, getting a lot of people, including your little ones' hopes up, by coming back and by playing first-class cricket, mm-hmm. but then possibly not to continue to play for the country again. What would you say if somebody were to ask you that?
Well, someone did ask me that.
Okay.
Yes. You see, there are two... I think there are two videos or three videos or something like that on YouTube.
Not enough.
Of me playing in innings, or otherwise just a few clips here and there. Because remember, I'm ancient, Aiden. So this is not, those are the days where it wasn't really covered as well as it is being covered now. So yes, there are he's got a couple of videos of me playing. I think one innings against New Zealand and one innings against against Kenya, if I'm not mistaken.
So here's another devil's advocate question. If you say that there are barriers between yourself and Zimbabwe cricket which may possibly prevent you from coming back and playing international cricket, but then if you say that it's Zimbabwe cricket's loss, not my loss, if you wanted to play cricket, then those barriers, surely they wouldn't be a problem, and that you would just focus on the future if you don't harbor any anger, disappointment, or anything towards Zimbabwe cricket. Could those barriers not be put aside in order for you to once again represent your country of birth?
Well, the barriers are not the ones to prevent me from playing. But the barriers are there to entertain the thought of me,
right,
coming to play. Because what I do when I'm making decisions is I try to stretch my thought at every stage up to the end. So when I'm stretching my thought to the end, if I see any barriers, I must be able to overcome those barriers in my mind first, before I actually go on the ground. Because when I hit the ground rolling, I hit to the end. You know me, Dean. When I make a decision, I make a decision.
Yes.
And I do not stop until I get to the end. So that is the part that I'm talking about. The entertaining of that thought first is what I have to go through in my mind. Because there are a lot of things to consider. We made a decision to move to the UK because my boy... Well, I thought I would give... a good education to my boys, because TJ wants to be a neurosurgeon. So I thought, well, let me take him to a school that I believe will be able to assist him in his dream, just the same way as a lot of people, made decisions for me to realize my dream. I should be able to do that for my boy. So we made a decision to move to the UK. And if I'm going to start to entertain the thought of maybe playing for my country again, I have to think about where we're going to be staying and things like that, and does that hinder this, that, and the other. And having looked at all that, I also have to look at, okay, how with where we've left with Zimbabwe cricket, how we get back, to the sitting ground to start to speak about how we're going to move on without revisiting what has transpired. Because what transpired last has never really been dealt with, if I'm to be honest, because it just happened. Because I move on, I just moved on. But I know a lot because I was part of the senior management team. So the things that people may not know outside, I know because I was inside.
And we will read that in the book?
That was really just too recent.
And
we just had to add one more chapter. But yes, some of it definitely is there.
Well, if you're a passionate reader of biographies, and if you follow Tatenda Taibu's story from when he started representing the national or the nation at in 2001, and when he then became Zimbabwe's first and also the world's youngest test captain and Zimbabwe's first black test captain in 2004, you will find his book a very, very interesting read indeed. Keeper of Faith by Tatenda Taibu. And it will be released on the 23rd of May. Well, don't forget that you can also subscribe to my YouTube channel, depending on which platform you're listening to this. You simply search for Dean Duplessis, and you can subscribe and listen to some fantastic interviews with the likes of Alan Donald, Andy Flower, Jason Gillespie, and believe me, there's more to come. Thank you very much indeed for listening, and we'll be back again very, very soon. But until then, it's goodbye.